My name is Warren Christensen. I'm an assistant professor of physics here at North Dakota State University, and I teach university physics, which is the first semester calculus-based introductory physics course. So this classroom space provides a lot of opportunities for different kinds of interactions that simply aren't possible within a traditional classroom. The classes that I've taught in before, I've taught in fixed seat lecture halls, which makes it very difficult to get students to talk with one another. And that's the thing, more than anything else, that research shows helps students learn. And these rooms are built and designed around student interaction and instructor-student interaction. So one of my favorite things that I get to do here is get students, like all of the students, at the same time, up working on the board, working on a problem. Because then it allows them to look at one another's work to make sure that everyone is actively involved and that nobody is sitting passively, not writing things down. It's a really great opportunity. You can't do that. I don't think there's any other classroom, even on campus, where you can do that. I think the students really seem to enjoy being in this space. We're asking them to do a lot of things. I mean, these are students who are majors in electrical engineering, physics, mathematics, computer science, and we're asking them to like go up to the board and work out problems, which nobody likes to do that. Like kind of showcases that you might not know what you're talking about. And in previous semesters, I always tried to highlight the fact that classroom time isn't for knowing. Classroom time is for learning. So if you don't know, that's okay. I didn't give students as many opportunities to struggle as I thought I had. Getting them up on the board, it's very clear when a student can't do something, and then I can further support them in saying, you know what, this is okay. Like, we can teach you how to do this. It's important now that I know that you didn't know, and so now let's kind of talk about how we can, you know, make better sense of this problem.